We're up to our knees in trouble, you know, and no mistake. But where we are, I haven't a clue. And we're not stopping to find out. Look there.
Well, this is a nice way to start a video. Hey guys, VGManiac456 here, and welcome back to some more Wallace and Gromit in Project Zoo. And last time we completed the mines, and this time we're going to complete the new world that we're in right now. So, yeah.
The emergency exits this way. I say, I'm not sure life on the edge agrees with me.
So yeah, welcome to what I call the lava caverns. I don't know what it's actually called, but I always called it the lava caverns. This area has a very annoying coin to get. As you saw, there is a target over there. As you can see, there's a target up there. In addition to that, there's a target way over there. Did I even get that? Maybe not over from over there. Yeah. There we go. No? Oh, there we go. I probably could have waited, but I decided against that. No. There it is. So we get our new item, which is actually a fire extinguisher. Here's an example for that. Well, extinguishes fire. What else do you expect? And yeah, nothing really else to say about it because it's just a fire extinguisher. Ouch. Okay. Oopsie daisies. Let's go. Personally, this is not my favorite level, world, whatever. Also, I hate, like I mentioned earlier, I don't like how the golden tool sound effect is. It bothers me so much because I'm like, where is it? Where is it? And yeah. Now, what we can do is this, or not. Okay, that's what I wanted to do. Stun it a little bit with the porridge gun, and then clobber it with a combo. Here's a golden tool. That is if I don't fall in the lava. Whew, that was close. And since we're not with Wallace, he's not gonna say, just the ticket. This will do nicely, or whatever. And lava is not usually instant death, mind you. Oh yeah, something I forgot to mention is that when you die, your ammo resets, but for some reason the porridge gun ammo does not. Basically, the porridge gun always sticks to 200. Nothing else. So, yeah, the other weapons, for some reason, they go back to their starting ammos, which is like 20 for the banana gun. And then there's like another gun that we're going to be getting much later on. And there we go. First token. Or coin. Whichever. And now we have something else to do. Again, I would recommend using the porridge gun because of its most ammo, because these guys will actually blow up on contact, so yeah. Now I know what you're thinking, why don't you roll underneath the gate now? Well, there's a reason for that, which will be coming apparent pretty soon. not just to escape from this area, but it's also to get a token. Yep. Very sneaky, I must agree. And plus, now the gate won't close on me ever again, and I don't have to mess with that little mini game. I didn't get hit. No, I didn't. Now it's gonna get a little annoying switching all weapons. Okay, so we have this catapult, which is gonna be pretty annoying. That is if I don't gum it down a little bit. And yeah. That was close. This is a very cleverly hidden tool. This took me a little while to figure it out. And okay. There we go. Ouch. I have a feeling this part will be a lot of deaths. And really? Put me all the way over here? Alright. Okay, then I guess I can't avoid that. Run. 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 Okay, let's just destroy these McGraws. Because I believe if I destroy them all, there's going to be a token that will pop up. How about you? There we go. So that's our third token. Let's get our fourth one. As soon as we get some crackers. That was like the most dangerous way to get crackers. Okay, I got the token. I don't have to mess with this ever again. I don't even remember if I got that ever. Okay. No. Aim at that. Yeah, okay. Any more targets all around the place? Nope. Okay, good. Much like the signs from earlier, I'm probably gonna miss one. I just know that. Oh, cool. I didn't die. Yet. Ouch! I'm gonna leave you alone. Okay. Okay, I can't go over there. I have a feeling I'm gonna get hit. Well, I did get hit. Does that count for something? Oh wow, I gotta top that. Okay, this is what you need to do. You need to light the torch and go on all the way back. I kinda kid you not. Why did I say I kinda kid you not? Because I really do mean that. You actually need to go over here. Jump. And walk over here carefully because there is steam. And you wanna avoid the steam. That explosion actually made me move. That's kind of interesting. Okay, let's extinguish all this fire, and then we'll be all set and ready to go. except not really, because we still need to grab this coin. If I can grab it. There we go. Yeah. It's just in my ear. Okay, drop down. And have another minigame. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is about the same switch puzzle that we've had multiples of times already. Nothing really has changed about it. Except I think you have less time. Phew! Got it. 6 tokens already. This is always my low running area, by the way. I always have trouble with this area. But upcoming is actually a bonus level already. Wow. Alright, so this one. Do you know Donkey Kong from the arcade? Well, guess what? This is Donkey Kong, only with a twist of Kaizo, I would say. You have a time limit, you can't touch the barrels, and there's a reason why there's a time limit. Oh, jeez, I think I goofed. Nope. Okay, you need to be quick about it, too. The barrels start to move faster and faster every time. No, 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 no. Okay. Oh boy! Not sure if I'll make it past the time limit. Oh, come on! Okay, this is why. Because there is a coin in the cage, and if you don't get there in time, the cage closes. But it's not the only coin here. Because you got another one right here. So yeah. Took a few tries, but I did it. And hello, barrel. 100 points. 200 points. 300 points. How about 400? Let's try 500. Let's try 600. Hello, Donkey Kong. Bye, Donkey Kong. And we finally find Wallace. Okay. I will in a little bit. Oh, I've almost missed
this
a target.
Way, then,
all right. So now the last target is over there, and kaboom! I remember this one always giving me trouble. This token was always one that always gave me trouble. So let's go ahead and grab that one. I'm sorry if I really have no idea where all the other tokens are at the moment, because I'm pretty sure I missed a few. Just have that feeling. But I'm just collecting as much as I can, as much as my memory goes, and if I miss any, then I'll backtrack for it, so yeah. Let's go down here for a golden tool, wherever that thing is. Oh, there it is. Whee!
That'll come in handy.
I also don't know what to say, because this is not really my favorite level of the game. So, really, I just feel like that I really have nothing really to say. I mean, I'm just commentating on what I'm doing. Now, there is a reason why I'm going back down here, because if you do, you get a token. If you do it, if you do this. As seen right here. Okay. 11 tokens gained. There is one token. I'm gonna note that right now. One token that I just simply cannot get. And it's this one coming right here. If anyone gives... Now... I just have no idea how to do this one at all. It basically asks you to go through a specific amount of gates at a specific amount of time, and what's bad is I don't know the actual route for that. No joke, I really have no idea. I mean, I'm gonna give this a shot, but if I don't get it, then you'll know why. Hey! Yeah! There we go! I did it! Alright, so we actually got, I believe, all the tokens that are possible to get in this particular...
Congratulations, old friend!
All the tokens or coins that we could get in this level. Or this area. So yeah. New area. Whew. You know... that's the first time I actually was able to do that. I don't remember ever being able to do that. That was actually not as tough as I thought it was. Oh, yeah, I need to... Oh, never mind. I just needed to wait for Wallace.